Okay, so let me just go over what we were doing. I started this summary, right? Suppose we have this AND order equation, and this is the characteristic equation which is obtained by replacing powers of y, no, derivatives of y with the powers of r. And if this equation has, let's say, distinct roots and distinct roots, okay, r1, rn, then the general solution of this is obtained as this expression, c1y1 plus c2y2 and so on. Ci's are real or complex numbers, and yi's are nothing but e to the power r1t, e to the power r2t, and so on. Moreover, an initial value problem of this type has a unique solution, right? Has a unique solution. And what is the corresponding system? Actually, this is the system we converted this ordinary differential equation into a first order system and solved that, right? This system has a solution like this. And the fundamental matrix of that solution is this gadget. And when you take the you take the determinant of this guy, you take r e to the power r1t e to the power rt2 out, you get this expression times a van der Mond matrix, right? We have 1 r1 r1 squared and so on, and then 1 r2 r2 squared and so on. The determinant of that matrix is nothing but product like this. And this expression is never zero since we assume that the roots are distinct. Okay, so this expression is never zero. This means that the solutions are linearly independent. This is really this thing is really the general solution. Okay. Okay. Well, then, as we had done in the systems, as in the case of systems, we consider this time equations where the characteristic equation may have non-real solutions. As a simple case, we consider a second order equation whose characteristic equation is this r squared plus r1 r plus r2. And let's say that this equation has two non-real solutions. Well, since they are non-real, the roots comes in complex pairs, conjugate pairs. One of them, say, is lambda plus I mu. The other one will be lambda minus I mu. And here I can assume that mu is a positive number, right? And then we write down the solutions. Well, for this root, I have the solution e to the power r1t. For this solution, I have the solution e to the power r2t. I plug lambda plus I mu for r1 and obtain this e to the power lambda t times e to the power I mu t. And from Euler's formula, e to the power I mu t can be written like this, right? And I open this up and obtain y1 equals this expression. What about y2? y2 is the same as y1. The only difference is that instead of mu, I have minus mu, so I replace mu by minus mu, and I get the second row. And here cosine absorbs this minus sine, but sine doesn't, right? It just spits out this minus sine, and you get this. And what we get, two non-real solutions, y1 and y2, has imaginary parts. To get rid of the imaginary parts, or maybe I should say, to obtain two real solutions, I just apply the trick we have used for systems, right? We had the same situation there. We just take the sum of these two and subtract difference of these two, and we see that they are real solutions. So if you take the arithmetic mean of these two solutions, y1 plus y2 over 2, you get the real part, which is e to the power lambda t cosine mu t, and the difference, y1 minus y2 divided by 2i, is another real solution. And we compute the Wronskian of these solutions, u, v, and their derivatives, and we see that this is never zero. Okay, this is never zero. U is e to the power lambda t cosine mu 2, I take its derivative. V is e to the power lambda t sine mu 2, I take its derivative. And we compute this determinant. It turns out that it is mu times e to the power lambda 2 lambda t. And we know that mu is never zero. I can assume it is positive, because I assume that my solutions are non-real, therefore imaginary part is not zero. Okay, all right, so we have this. And what is the general solution then? It is just y equals c1. Well, maybe I should write u and v here, and they are just this, it is just this expression. All right, so let's do some example. Let's say this is the equation, and I want to find the general solution. We write down the characteristic equation. So it is just r squared plus r equals 0. And from this, r squared plus 1 equals 0. From this we get r equals plus minus I. So this is lambda plus minus I mu, where lambda is 0 and mu is equal to 1. Okay. So what are the corresponding solutions? U is e to the power lambda t cosine mu t. So it is just lambda is 0. So e to the power 0t, which is just 1, cosine mu is just 1, so it is just this. And this is the same thing. So this is just sine t. Therefore, hence the general solution. The general solution is y equals c1 times cosine t and c2 times sine t. Okay. Let me do another example. Examples 1 and 2. Actually, let's consider an RLC circuit. So, so I have this. Okay, so we apply some potential here. I have a resistance, a capacitor, and an inductor. And let's say Yt is the charge in the capacitor. Then the differential equation satisfied by Y is this. We studied this before. So Y prime is the current. Y prime is the current. It, right? Current. So the potential difference here is just R times I. R times I. And the potential difference here is just the current, charge divided by C. And the potential difference here is just L times the derivative of the current. And this is ET. So it is just L times Y double prime plus R times Y prime plus 1 over C times Y equals ET. So our equation has this type. Okay. Assume ET is 0. Okay, then the equation becomes what? Y double prime plus, L times Y double prime plus R times Y prime plus 1 over C times Y equals 0. And assume that so what is the characteristic equation? Characteristic equation is just RL squared plus L R squared plus R times R plus 1 over C equals 0. Okay, and let's say L is 1, R is 2, and C is 1 over 2, 1 over 2. Then equation becomes what? R squared plus 2R plus 2 equals 0. And what are the roots? R1 and 2 are just minus 2 plus minus b squared, which is 4 minus 4 ac, which is 8 divided by 2. So R1 is minus 1 plus I, and R2 is minus 1 minus I. So they have the form lambda plus I mu. Lambda is 1, minus 1, and mu is 1. Okay, mu is 1. So what are the corresponding solutions? E to the power lambda t. From this we get u is e to the power lambda t cosine mu t. So it is e to the power minus t cosine t, and v is e to the power lambda t sine mu t, e to the power minus t sine t. So what is the solution then? Y is just c1 times e to the power, maybe I should write e to the power minus t c1 times cosine t plus c2 times sine t. Okay, so this is the charge, right? This is the general solution. And this is the charge. Charge in the capacitor C. Right? Here we assume external force or potential is zero. So this means I have a short circuit here, but we have some initial charge here. Initial charge. Okay. So my circuit is like this. Okay, R, L, C, and suppose we have some initial charge. Let's say Y zero equals what? One initial charge and initial current. Let's say this is zero, no initial current, only the charge. Then let's find the solution. Well, I had this solution. So what was it? Okay, e to the power minus t c1 cosine t c2 sine t. What about its derivative? So it is e to the power minus t c1 cosine t plus c2 sine t plus e to the power minus t, and then derivative of this minus c1 minus sine t plus c2 cosine t. All right. Plugging the initial conditions, 0 equals 1 equals y0. So if I plug 0 here, I get e to the power 0, which is 1. Cosine 0 is 1. Sine 0 is 0. So I have only c1. And the second initial condition, which was y prime 0. So when I plug 0 here, this becomes 0, this becomes 0. So I have minus c1, and then I have plus c2. All right. So from this, we get c2 is c1, which is just 1. Hence we have the following solution then. Hence, the charge in the capacitor, which is yt, is equal to e to the power minus t, and then c1 and c2 are 1, so this is just cosine t plus sine t. Okay. So, bunu aslında şöyle de yazabiliriz sanırım. Nedir bu? Şöyle diyeyim. Şimdi cosine A çarpı cosine T cosine sine A sine T olsaydı bu nedir? Bu cosine A artı T olacaktı. Değil mi? A artı T olacaktı. Ya da A eksi T belki. Ya da T eksi A diyeyim. Evet. Bu durumda Bir dakika. Şöyle yapsaydık. Tamam. Şunu şöyle yazayım. Evet. Kök 2 parantezini alırsam bir bölü kök 2 kosine t artı 1 bölü 2 sine t olur. Kök 2 parantezinde. Dolayısıyla a'yı pi bölü 4 seçersem bu 1 bölü kök 2, 1 bölü kök 2 olur. Dolayısıyla da bu qt şöyle bir şey çıkacak. Cosine t minus pi over 4. Tam da böyle değil. Pardon, şöyle kök 2 times pi over 4. Değil mi? 1 bölü kök 2, 1 bölü kök 2. So, we have then something like this as the solution. So the charge in the capacitor will be something like this. T eşittir sıfırdaysa bu kosinüs pi bölü T eşittir sıfırsa bu burası 1. Değil mi? Zaten sıfırdaki değeri bunun 1'di. Ondan sonra dikkat ederseniz şimdi şurada pardon. Şöyle diyeyim. Şurada kök 2 şurada bir yerde. Eksi kök 2 de burada bir yerde. Bu kosinüsün grafiği. Ama shift edilmiş biraz. Shift edilmiş. T pi bölü 4 olduğunda kosinüs 0 yani maksimuma ulaşacak. Bunun grafiği şöyle bir şey olacak arkadaşlar. Ben size çizeyim. Şu ev üzeri eksi t olmasaydı, ev üzeri t eksi t olmasaydı şöyle olacaktı. Evet. Şurası şu. Kök 2 çarpı kosinüs t eksi pi bölü 4. E üzeri t eksi olunca ne olacak? T arttıkça dalganın genliği değil mi, azalacak. Yani şeyleri aynı olacak. Periyot aynı şekilde gidecek. Ama sürekli azalacak. Yani şöyle. Ve en sonunda sıfıra doğru gidecek QT. O da bu. Root 2 e to the power minus t cosine t minus pi over 4. So what happens actually? We have some initial charge in the capacitor. We have some charge here. When you make a short circuit, charge just goes through the circuit. But in a oscillating, as an alternating current with a certain frequency, it goes back and forward. And since we have this resistor here, the energy of the system gets decreased in time. Therefore, the wave will just get, smaller and smaller and it will finally vanish. But it has a certain frequency and here in this case frequency is just 1, right? Or 1 over 2 pi or something like this. Okay. So here I should maybe, what is this? This is yeah, this is pi over 4 when it reaches its maximum. This is pi over 2, cosine is 0, and then this is bir dakika. Evet, 3 pi over 4. Burası pi. Evet, ve bu şekilde gidiyor. Yani efendim? 5 pi bölü 4. Bir dakika. Yani bir dakika. Pi bölü 4 olduğunda maksimum değerini alacak. Pi bölü 2 olduğunda evet haklısın. Bunun sıfır olması için burasının pi bölü 2 artı pi bölü 4 olması lazım ki pi bölü 4 çıkarttığımda şey olsun. Bu da nedir? 3 pi bölü 4 burası. Burası da evet pi 5 pi bölü 4 haklısın. Bu şekilde gidecek. Burası pi kadar artıyor. Pi kadar arttığına göre 7 pi bölü 4 olacak. Burası bu şekilde gidecek. Tamam. Okey. Alright. So let me stop at this point.